Just a few updates on the status of our infrastructure here in the city. Our goal right now is to make this city operable for our residents who are here, which is somewhere in the neighborhood of 200,000, and get our city ready for the folks who need to come back, somewhere in the neighborhood of 200,000. And we're going to do that, and we're doing it right now. And thank you, Chief Nelson, for talking about the folks who do this very complicated technical work in very dangerous situations at the moment. It's a humbling to be a part of folks from the Sewage and Water Board doing things to keep our sewer system going, the DPW parkways and sanitation clearing our roads, etc. By the end of a couple updates. One, we're not only recovering, but we're in the peak of hurricane season. We're keeping our eyes on the weather, and as such, we have so much debris out there. I cannot state this enough. There is so much debris out there that we have, we're only pushing it. Right now, what that means is we're cutting, removing trees that are down. We've resolved somewhere in the neighborhood of 80 major streets that have been completely impassable via trees. There are some trees that are still out there in the middle of the street laying down. Avoid them. Many of them are tied up with Entergy distribution lines, and the line men and women of Entergy are working on those, so give them space. There's a tremendous amount of roof nails and debris in the streets. If you're driving around and you blow a tire because of the equipment out there, it's really hard to get a new tire right now. So drive slowly, evade all debris that's out there, only if you even have to be on the streets. On Friday, the Department of Public Works is planning to issue the notice to proceed for a contract for 15 to 20 vac trucks to begin sucking out all of the debris that is wafted into our subsurface drainage line. Thus far, we've cleared 3,000 linear feet of completely clogged drain line. We have 32 blocks have been cleared of debris. Debris, I want to be clear, will not be picked up until at the earliest next week. We're pushing it to the right-of-ways. If you're working on your home, take your debris, put it on the curb. We're going to push some messaging out about what the methods and structure of how that debris should be pushed out there. We've cleared 119 catch basins on day three of the recovery, fully vacuumed them. That's not just clearing the front of them. Hopefully residents can step up and do that. Cleared another 59 manholes. We've placed stop signs at every major intersection surrounding both the pods, those sites where you can pick up food and water, and the cooling center. So if you're driving to those sites, follow those stop signs. Again, as a reminder, virtually none of our stoplights are functioning in the city, with the exception of the ones that have come on this morning. Every intersection, unless there is a functioning stoplight, which I can assure you there are few, if any, is a four-way stop sign. Crews are removing and repairing down poles and streetlights as we see them. In terms of debris, we have 11 crews worked yesterday pushing debris on the sides of the roads. We have another 14 crews working today. Those are contracted debris crews that are coming in to do this work. Yesterday I mentioned we have limited trash collection starting tomorrow. More information will come out about that later this evening. But at the moment, we're trying to structure who's available and what our forces can do. At this moment, our sanitation contractors have very limited staffing, very limited access to power, and so we have to be really strategic when we can start picking up trash. Today, we're clearing the main routes of Esplanade, Orleans, Canal, Broad to City Park, St. Bernard, Jefferson, and Norman Francis. It's a lot of the Endymion / Zulu routes, ironically, as I read those. Contractors, no earlier than Tuesday for all active job sites. No earlier than Tuesday are our contractors gonna start work. We're gonna see where power is, but our contractors on active job sites throughout the city, if you are out of town and you left your job site, you are getting a lot of input from us saying, hey, come on down, clean it up, make it safe. Contractors should be doing that. If you do not see that, call 311, report that to us. Additionally, I got a note from HDLC. If you have a damaged house in a historic district or a damaged building, don't wait for a permit to secure it from the elements. The city is gonna be very accommodating to ensure that your building doesn't have any water incursion. And then finally, on City Hall power, Yesterday, you may recall, we had a transfer switch on the 11th floor. Transfer switch on the 11th floor, 500 kW generator, led down to a backup battery on the third floor in information technology. Information technology is largely coming back online now. You can go on our website. Our information largely is on there. It's coming back. And we have an 800 kW generator that showed up late last night under state police escort, which is getting wired to City Hall. And it's kind of a race between Entergy and the generator to see which one will come on first. And finally, Sewage and Water Board, our drinking water is safe, remains safe. Pressure is stable. Sewage and Water Board, by the end of the day today, we should be tracking to have 35 of 85 Sewage and Water Board sewer lift stations on by the end of the day. That's the goal, and those would be generator power. But as the distribution center system comes back online, Sewage and Water Board lift stations come back online. But our message to the public is restrict your use of wastewater continuing as much as possible. We're gonna get the city back in shape so folks here can move around, be safe, and enjoy what New Orleans is, and y'all can come home who are out of town as soon as possible.